American girl. Texting, tweeting, boyfriends, breakups, nails, hair, makeup, clothes. Choice. You are a first world society teenage girl. You wake up, you get dressed, you go to school, you choose your education, you choose your future, you choose who you love and when you love them. You are a woman of choice. Or are you? You're 15 and you're in Pakistan. You're doing your homework at the kitchen table when your brother comes in and shoots you in the head because you're allegedly sleeping with a man. Or your very own parents come in and splash acid in your face because you looked at a man wrong, which shamed your family. You are not a woman of choice. Who have you heard of? Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie or Beyonce? Most likely Beyonce. As Beyonce takes the pop music industry by storm, Chimamanda takes the female activism and literature sectors by storm as well. These two powerful women paired up to create a song, which is a feminist masterpiece titled Flawless. I will play a clip now, which pairs Chimamanda's powerful words with Beyonce's music.
We teach girls to shrink themselves, to make themselves smaller. We say to girls, you can have ambition, but not too much. You should aim to be successful, but not too successful. Each other's competitors, not for jobs or for accomplishments, which I think can be a good thing, but for the attention of men. We teach girls that they cannot be sexual beings in the way that boys are. Feminist, a person who believes in the social, political, and economic equality of the sexes.
This comes from a larger talk given by Chimamanda in 2013 titled, Why We Can All Be Feminists. I love Chimamanda and grow greatly from her messages, but I can't help but to find a bone of contention in the title of her talk. There are two problems in modern day feminism, so much so, we cannot all be feminists yet. In order to change that idea, we need to solve the problems of feminism. Why We Cannot All Be Feminists, problem number one, the connotation. I am not a feminist. I am a humanist. And those two words are not synonymous. But if they were, the movement would be much stronger, much larger. In theory, a feminist is one who advocates the social, political, and economic rights of women. So, to retract my previous statement, I am a theoretical feminist. What I am not is the connotative feminist. Now, I'm sure everyone has their ideas of what a feminist may be, some positive, some negative, and unfortunately, common stereotypes dominate the field, and these stereotypes ruin the message of feminism. A few popular ones include grumpy old women who can't get husbands, manly women, women who don't shave, women who despise chivalry, man-haters, and women who don't care about their appearance. So, I'd like to say I'm not a connotative feminist. I take care of my appearance, I don't hate men, and I find chivalry adorable. And my dad can surely attest that I can be pretty grumpy, but not for the perceived feminist reasons of not having a man. Now, not all feminists live up to these stereotypes. In fact, most of the feminists I know don't live up to any of them. And even if one did, that does not reflect upon the whole movement. Just like in the civil rights movement, some people practice civil disobedience that did not make the whole movement an act of civility. Another connotative problem with feminism is the idea that men cannot be feminists. Now, men make up give or take 50% of the world population, so right there, that's 50% who cannot be feminists by this connotation. Now, as I will address later, this is not true, and every gender can become a feminist. Problem number two with feminism, the prioritization. Now, here's where opinions may divert, but I personally feel the United States American feminist agenda does not address important issues in the world. While we focus on what we can wear in school, girls abroad cannot go to school at all. While we work to defeat wage gaps, women abroad cannot work at all. As we try to knock down gender roles, other countries substantiate them. And as we protest for reproductive rights, alarmingly high rape statistics increase elsewhere, increasing unwanted poverty and pregnancy. So, I'm not trying to say that the United States goals are not powerful and needed. All I'm saying is that there are areas elsewhere that we should focus on. As Chimamanda so powerfully stated in her 2013 talk, she cannot complain about not having shoes when the person she was speaking to had no legs. American women have a voice. It's time for us to speak out for those who do not. Now, there is a way we can all become feminists, and that's by redefining feminism. Feminism needs to be looked at on a broader scale. Human rights. Because women take the brunt of the force, but that does not mean that everyone doesn't get hurt by these women-targeted approaches. Humanism. One who advocates the universal human welfare, values dignity and agency. One who believes everyone has the right to make their own choices and advocate for their own lives. One who promotes human rights recognition. So, if I'm a humanist, I'm a feminist. If I care about human rights, I by default care about women's rights. This is why humanism is the Bandaid for feminism. So, if we join together, we reinvest our energy, and we knock down the stigmas, we can all be feminists. And, most importantly, we can join together and advocate universal human welfare. Thank you.